to wait, 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 wait. Tico, 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 tap. Tico, tick. Oh, tico, 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 tap. Tico, tick. Oh, tico, 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 tap. Tico, tick. Oh, tico, tico, tap. This tico, tico is a cuckoo in my car.
Okay, so a little change of pace today. I'm out at the pier at 125th Street, Manhattan, on the west side. We're gonna look for what's in the Hudson today. Hoping for striper, but I know there's bluefish, there's eels, there's white perch. Some of the smaller fish are gonna have a hard time with the hook I have on there right now, though. The Hudson has a very strong current, so I actually have 4 ounces of weight on there, on like a little clip slide thing, and then past the slide is a barrel swivel that has the leader attached to it with a piece of clam. I also have a bell attached to my rod tip, so when I hear a bell, I know that maybe there's a fish on there. So that'll also be a good way to know when I should turn the camera on. All right. So I also have a smaller line going out to catch presumably smaller fish, just less weight on it. So even with the weight, it's probably gonna drift, but that's okay. We're trying to find the fish right now. So it's a little piece of shrimp on there. And I should have mentioned, it's about an hour and a half or so from high tide. High tide is supposed to be at 8:45 this evening. It's supposed to be a good time to fish in and around high tide. So I might stick around for a while tonight, maybe till 11, 11:30, depending on, you know, what I feel like, I guess. So something was biting, but I don't think there's anything on there. Okay, just to check in, it's about 9 o'clock, actually 8:43, so 2 minutes from high tide. It started raining, so there's not nearly as many people out here on the pier as there were before. In fact, there's just a few. No news. I've definitely been getting little bites, especially on my bigger rod. And this one actually looks like it's going crazy, but I think it's just the current. Let's see if it starts doing it again. I don't know if you can even see it in this light, but yeah, I think that's just the current, but we'll check. This is just to catch some little things, but the bigger rod, there's definitely been a lot of little nibbles, maybe just little fish or perhaps even crabs. The bells will ring just a little bit, and then when I'll check, there's just, I'll try to set the hook or whatever and nothing's there. Or it could just be a smart fish who knows how to yank it off there. But the key is, so I'm using clams, and there's like a meaty, tough part of it. I'm not sure what that anatomical term for it is, but there's a really tough part of it, and that's where you want to put the hook through so that it doesn't just slide off at the slightest touch or even when entering the water. But I'm down to my last clam already, which sucks because it's high tide, but I still have some shrimp left. I even have some like catfish dough ball type things that will put a nice chicken blood and garlic scent. You can actually just straight up put the dough ball on there, but that stuff falls apart really quick. So hopefully this other seafood can last us. All right, so my clams are gone. I've got some shrimp left, as I've stated earlier. But I was trying to think, what can I do if there are things biting and they're just stealing from my line? What can I do to make sure they don't steal my bait? So what I did, I put a big piece of shrimp on my big hook, and luckily I brought along some line, some extra fishing line. So I actually like kind of tied it on, just wrapped around the fishing line around the shrimp a bunch of times after it was already on the hook, and I'm gonna see if maybe I can I've outfoxed them somehow. All right, we've got the bell going off a little bit, but it still might be these little things. I'm waiting for a big shake. And this is only a couple minutes later. But maybe in another minute or so. Oh, okay. There's the bell. You might have heard it. There we go. Now, here's the moment of truth, where if we don't have a fish, we'll see if the bait stayed on. I'll know pretty quickly. I know what it feels like when there's a fish. Sometimes it's tough when there's a lot of weight on there to tell. Yeah, I don't think we have a fish. So my best guess is that these are just really small things that are toying with us, but I'm interested to see if the bait stayed on. Weird. The hook. It's just like a big. So look, there's the bait hanging off of the line, and there's the hook, which is empty. Okay, I have something. I have something on my small line. It's probably, I don't know. Ooh, that might be. Oh, it's an eel? Eel! Got an eel! Got an eel, guys! Yep, a little eel. Now, hold on a second. These guys are kind of nasty. Yeah, it's pretty disgusting, and he's gonna probably put my arm in a death wrap. Yep, they're not fun to unhook. Okay, where's the hook? Did he swallow it? Let's see here. No, he didn't, but what he did do, he managed to get the line wrapped all around him. Thing keeps, oh, there we go. Just gonna get a shot of it for my film. All right, so, oh man, where's the lighting good here? That's an American eel, and might be the only thing I catch all night, but that was fun. I'm gonna just throw him back. Man, he slimed me. Oh God, they're slimy. Guess I could have used him for cut bait, but I have enough cut bait, so. Ugh. Look at that glove. Yuck. Thank you. Glad you could witness the whole thing. That's probably the only thing I'm going to catch all night. All right, for a second there, it almost looked looks like we have something. Yep, we definitely have something else on the small line. Maybe just something. Nah, something biting it though. Hey, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this, but remember when the eel slimed me? Watch this. It's like dead skin, except it's eel slime. Comes right off. It's kind of fun to peel off though. Used to do this with glue in elementary school. Minus the hair, of course. But that is a big, 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 big boat. Took the meat right out. It was a piece of shrimp, and they took the meat right out of the shell. Ooh, I think I have something. Feels like it. Maybe another eel? Oh, he was clinging on to it, but he let go. I saw him, folks, so it's just about 11 p.m. I've been here for about 4 hours. Saw the tide rise, and now it's been falling for about 2 hours. I was happy to get that one American eel. That was cool. That was my first eel of 2017, which is nice. And, you know, it was a nice, slow night, but just have to come right back out here and... You're kidding me. You're kidding me. You're kidding me. Is that a fish? No, it's not a fish.
The one my heart has gone to may not want to wait.